Hi, I'm Colin, and today we're going to talk about some mistakes to avoid when removing efflorescence, as well as how to fix them. Efflorescence is a white, chalky, or sometimes blue, hazy substance that comes naturally from the cement content in your paving stone through moisture. Muriatic acid has kind of been the standardized way to remove that, and muriatic acid is basically diluted hydrochloric acid. There are other efflorescence cleaners out there that can provide you with similar results, but they may be costly, and that cleaner might not be readily available to you, while muriatic acid more than likely is. When using muriatic acid to remove efflorescence, the most important thing is going to be your safety. This is a very, very harsh chemical, not just the substance potentially getting on your skin, but those vapors entering your respiratory system. So you want to make sure you have the proper PPE or personal protective equipment, including gloves to cover your skin, glasses to cover your eyes, and even a face shield to cover your face, as well as a vapor respirator to reduce the chance of those vapors getting into your respiratory system, as they can be incredibly harmful. The biggest mistake that can be made when using muriatic acid to remove efflorescence, besides not having the right safety equipment, is using the wrong dilution ratio. Everybody's products are going to be made of different cements and aggregates, so they'll handle this efflorescence removal a little bit differently. When we're doing our materials, we usually start with a 21-to-1 ratio. That's 21 parts water and 1 part muriatic acid when we're trying to remove efflorescence. If it doesn't get all of it removed the first time, we could do multiple lifts at that dilution ratio and reduce the amount of damage to the top of our stones. What you're basically doing is degrading your stones to make them all look uniform while removing that efflorescence. So it is a bit of a trade-off. You're making them look a little bit older and weathered, but you are removing that white, hazy substance from the tops of your pavers. Aside from the risk of damaging your products with this muriatic acid ratio, you could actually harm some metals nearby, especially if it's galvanized. This dilution ratio, even at that high rate of 21-to-1, will strip the galvanizing right off of steel and promote rust very, very rapidly. We've learned through trial and error that this dilution ratio doesn't do anything to plants or grass, but again, the risk is mainly if there's any galvanized metal nearby that it can splatter or splash onto that will remove that galvanizing. If you accidentally used too much muriatic acid or efflorescence cleaner during this process and exposed the aggregate in that stone or removed a lot of those fines, you're only left with a couple different options. Option one is to leave the material the way it is and hope that everything deteriorates evenly over time. The second option is to replace those individual stones or areas with new products to make it look as good as possible. They won't match the exact same, but you still will have a functional hardscape. So if you have to remove efflorescence, we hope this video was helpful to you on what to do and what not to do. If you want to learn more projects you can do by yourself in the paving stone world, check out our website, westerninterlock.com, or our how-to videos on YouTube at Western Interlock.